Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Rabi-Ribi. In this episode, we're gonna go collect this that final shot type I've been talking about so much. And we're finally gonna recruit a Shuri too, 'cause I know where to find her now. So let's first go back to the Golden River Bank. Game froze for a moment there for some reason. Okay, map. Map, map, map. I'm supposed to go where I fought Ashuri last time, but it's been a while. So you'll just have to bear with me a moment as I try and get my bearings straight. Sorry about that, got called away. Anyways, I just remembered there's a few areas I didn't explore yet. But I'll probably tackle that a bit later. No, since I'm here, I might as well do it now. But first, let's see if I can find that one room I left off on. Ah, stupid rock. In fact, where are my badges? I want to put my contact damage badge back on! Or fire orb or what? Wait. Yeah, that's the fire orb that does that, doesn't it? Oh, it's been so long since I played that. This is going to be useless in the upcoming fight. But it'll become useful for a later fight. Oh, I definitely want to put this back on. And I kind of want to put this on too, because being locked into that combo is kind of irritating. Okay. Okay. All right, I should be fine now. Oh, right, can't go up that way. It's a slide passage. Oh, whoops, I got numbed. Oh, no, I didn't get numbed. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, bunny cultists. You will not be missed. Oh, too many enemies! Well, there's a save point, so I should be right next to where I need to be. Or close to it. Right, I think I went through that passageway before. But then I go for this one. Yeah, it looks like I did. Okay. I got something from there. Yeah, this is the room I left off on. Okay. So let's go through this room. Yeah, there it is. Finally. The explode shot. And I believe that's all the shot types there are, though. I guess if you tried hard enough, you could fit an eighth shot type. Like white or something like that on the bar there, but that's just me. Let's see what this does. Oh yeah, it fires off that orb thing. Wait, that's the wrong way. There's the rock. I want to try this on. Okay. Yeah, it functions very similar to the plasma shot from Mega Man X4. Where it just sticks to something and then it continuously does damage. Not bad. But I don't think it would be as useful in this game because all the enemies just keep moving around and it's hard for them to stay in place for too long. Alright. I want to explore some more of a Evernight Peak, because... Oh wait, you're not enemies. Whoops. I want to explore more of Evernight Peak, because as you can see, there's a few areas I didn't visit yet. And apparently I didn't go down there either. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, that's a one-way platform. Oh! Yeah, I'll just use this as convenient little cover. Bye-bye. And what is this? Plus necklace. Rapid shock frequency increased. Okay, that's a nice little power-up, I guess. Let's see how well it works. I don't think I'm understanding how it works. Where is it? Huh. Okay, I guess I'll have to upgrade that a bit before I can use it effectively. Because it has a little circle next to it. Yeah, now that I think about it, I should probably fight some more of these enemies, because I need the extra cash. Oh, hush you. Get out of my face. Okay, that's a one-way passageway. Let's see what's up here. Okay, then! There's a secret passageway here. Right, then. I think there was something else I missed. So many enemies! On that note, I've been playing quite a bit of Skylanders Giants as of late. I'm trying to beat Skylanders Giants using only the giant figures on hard difficulty. I don't think I'll be able to do my nightmare mode because that is just a little too hard for having such a big and bulky Skylander like that. Which is kind of a shame. I like the Giants. They're neat. And then, Activision and Toys for Bob had to go ahead and make figures that were just as big as the Giants, but had more functionality. And no light core. And no light core parts that can light up when you put the figure on the portal of power. Well, aren't we just little bundles of joy today? Seriously, what's with all these fairies? Alright, let's head this way. Nope, nothing's here. If I keep going up this way, I'm just gonna hit the dead end again, hit the previous area again. So let's go down. Hello! I see a thing there! I want the thing! Give me the thing! Cashback! Hello! What does this do? Increase EN gained from enemies. Alright, yes, please. What do I gotta do to sacrifice it, though? I guess I could do without the poison strike for now. Alright. This will come in handy for, cash farming, I guess. So what's further down here? Huh, this just connects back to an earlier segment. Okay, good to know. Did I go everywhere here? Looks like. Okay, now I just have to find my way back to a save point so I can go back to the Spectral Cave and do whatever it is I'm gonna do there. Oh, that's the wrong way. These enemies are just really ruthless today. They keep chasing me. Hold still. Alright, what is on top of me? Oh, your laser passes through walls. That's lovely. How did I forget about that? Oop! Yeah, I'm just gonna charge over to Winter Wonderland. Oop. Okay, there has to be something down here. There's a huge open space below, and hello there. And, wait. Didn't I just come down and explore around here? Wow, I'm a dummy. I forgot there was an Easter egg hidden here. Now, where is the nearest teleport? I think if I go up to the palace, it'll be a little faster. Bee! Bye, Bee! Nobody likes you, Bee! I do not like you. Bees are cute, but they are also dangerous! And I gotta keep... Or do I have to? Oops. There we go. Alright then. Now we've got a bit more cash. Let's head back to Rabi-Ribi Town and buy some more stuff. Alright, what do you got for me, Coco? Oh, excuse me. That reminds me, Miriam's not back yet. I guess she's still recovering? I don't know. Let's upgrade this, plus necklace now. Upgrade even more. Okay. I guess I got all the important items to level 3. Well, except this one. I don't have this one yet. Did I even get this yet? Weird. Well, I have enough money for some, extra mana. But I think the pack-up is a little more valuable, so I'll buy that. Alright, then. Let's head back to the Spectral Cave. Because I recall that there was something I have to do there to... Yeah. I'm aware of what I have to do to get a Shuri back to town, and that involves going back to a familiar room. Oh yes, the Rainbow Crystal. Oh yes. It's finally about time we go into that one room I kept fantasizing about, like, forever. I do kind of miss the poison strike, though. What the? Where'd you go? Did you just get launched into space or something? And how are you shooting through walls, you... Stupid rabbit. Begone. Begone with ye! Oh, I shouldn't have run off the ledge like that. Well, I'm at least on the right track, so, Can you please die? Thank you. Actually, I think I went the wrong way. If I go down from here, then I can reach the save point easily. Right, I keep forgetting about this area. It's all wall jump mazes and whatnot. Alright. Oh, why did I jump there? I mean, sure, my character is pretty much invincible at this difficulty, but still, kind of inconvenient. Alright, and... Oh, cutscene? Oh, great. Weren't they supposed to not be here first? Oh, great. Oh boy. Yeah. I'm sure it'll be just fine. But just to be on the safe side, let's make a save here. Alright then. Now I have to fall all the way back down. Fight past these enemies. I have no idea why I'm bothering, but... But darn it, I want more money! Where's my money at? Where's my money? Okay, yeah, that was kind of a poor joke, but... Just that one scene from Family Guy where Stewie beats up Brian is just hilarious to me, for some odd reason. Not that I suggest you guys watching it, because it is pretty brutal, but still. It's cartoon violence. It's not actual violence. Alright. Let's, go in and fight this obvious boss that's in here. Yep. I am pretty sure something is gonna happen here. Shaking? Oh. Well, there's the Rainbow Crystal. Oh, it's got multiple variants to it. Okay. Yeah, it's got like 7 health meters. Oh. Okay, it's attacking individually now. Oh dear. I thought I'd have to bomb through that somehow. Oof! Aye! My dodging skills are not up to snuff today! Oh, geez. Oh, why did I do that? I literally ran right into that. Oh. Well, I'm staying alive at least. This is probably the easiest crystal to dodge so far. Oh great, it's buzzing. Randomly buzzing. Okay, this helped a bit. Oh great, it's doing this attack again. Wait, did I destroy one of the crystals? Yes, I did! Good. Oh great, now they're shooting more bullets. Oops. That was a poor use of an amulet. Ooh, how did I dodge all that? My hitbox is tiny. Oh, I'm too late. Oh, it got me. Oh great, now it's doing it again. Okay, that's two down. Okay, I probably should have amuleted there. It seems like the crystals heal slightly too, but not by a lot. Oh, why did I do that? Oh well, it doesn't matter. I think I'm over the hard stuff now. Yeah, I can see them healing themselves after the fact. Okay. Yeah, their attacks are becoming more intense as the battle goes on. I really don't like these homing attacks. Ay, ay, ay! And now they're spinning again, always spinning. Maybe if I just park myself here and get poked a bunch of times by bullets. Yeah, that strategy did not work out so well. Oh, great, now I have the purple gem to deal with. There we go, it's dead. And there goes that Cave Story-esque explosion again. All right, we did it. All right, well, I guess that's over and done with, so let's claim our prize. Tough skin. This does resist toxic, curse, and burn effects. Oh goodness, this would have been helpful in the Kotri boss fight. Seriously. But, oh well. Hindsight is always 20/20. And I got quite a bit of cash out of that, so, now that I have this crystal, I can, oh. Hey, there she is! Alright, yeah, this is the final quest line we needed to do to get Ashuri into the village. But now I'm still confused. How the heck do you get back up to that one save point? I guess you're supposed to Do this? Oh, I couldn't quite reach it. Drat! Okay, well, everyone's obliterated, so it doesn't really matter now. I can just, make my way back. There we go! Yeah! Air dash! Air dash for the win! Go deeper into the Forgotten Cave. Oh yeah, that's my, only objective here, isn't there? But no, I'm gonna have to do some serious preparation for that. So, let's first go back to town and get to a teleport stone. Yeah, I don't want to keep staring at this. I know where to go, I just have to get my brain to tell me how to get there. Yep, here we are. Teleport away. Right then, so let's go ahead and purchase a few pack-ups. That should be enough to help me equip this badge I got. Yep, more than enough. And I can probably put on Toxic Strike, too. Great! This is very good, and on that note, how many of these do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Well, I have an excess of badges, so I could equip the Death Grow badge. But I still don't have quite enough to do that. Oh well, I'm not gonna worry too much about it. What I am gonna do is, see if I can go back to the cavern I visited. To the Forgotten Cavern, I mean. Where is it? Oh, okay, apparently there's no actual warp for the Forgotten Cavern. Weird. Unless I didn't find it yet for some reason, I don't know. So, I guess I'll just teleport back to the forest. Ah, this lovely, lovely music. Alright, we'll just, save our game here and call it good. So, thank you for watching this video, and next time, we'll find out what's at the very back of the Forgotten Cave. I'm gonna dedicate an entire video to it, and boy, it's gonna be a long one. So, stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, have a good day.